Hi, this is Dan Cuscarella, Camplex Fiber Optics. I'm here with some tips for your fiber optic network, sponsored by our partner, TechNet Distributing. What I want to talk about is a variety of methods that will ensure that your fiber optic cable is not the weakest link in your chain. One of the most important aspects of fiber optic cables is keeping your fiber optic cable clean. Now, mind you, we all have good practice in our industry, and relatively, our cables are clean. In general, for coax and other copper signals, it's a moot point. But for fiber optics, because fiber optic cables, a single mode cable is 9 micron, thinner than a human hair, simple things such as the dust and particulates in the air can block some of the light in your cable, or the oil and grease that may be on your hands, and certainly are on mine. But if you've ever been in your living room on a Sunday afternoon looking at the light flowing in through the window, you notice that there's particulates in the air. And again, those are going to cause some light to be blocked in your fiber optic chain. And it's important to ensure your network is stable and reliable. You're cleaning, storing, managing, and deploying fiber optic cables properly. If you've got oil and grease on your hand, and that gets on your fiber optic cable, and that's not even too bad. That's good news. My hands are pretty clean. But there you go. You can see that that oil and grease could potentially cause damage to your network. And because fiber optic cables are a physical contact, you're connecting one cable physically to another cable. The glass to glass end face is touching. You're transferring that oil and grease. So we recommend, again, every time, a simple little tool, one-click cleaner. I like to call them a two-click cleaner. Why not? It's simple. One, two. Plug your cable into your tester if you have one. Now, this is a fiber inspection scope, but you can see that all that oil and grease is removed. I do have a little chip on the end of this cable. It is outside the end face of the cable, so that's not too bad. But it's very important that you're cleaning and maintaining those fiber optic cables. If you're not, your cable may become the weakest link in your chain, and your system may go down at a mission critical event merely because you didn't maintain a cable simple as 1-2 clicks. Additionally, you may want to invest into one of my favorite tools, a VFL. Now, this VFL is a visual fault locator. And what that does is it sends a visual light down the path of your fiber optic cable or even in your network. This helps you identify when you're violating bend radiuses. As you can see here, the light starts to escape this cable as I bend it. Or even if there's a break in your cable. Right here, there's obviously a glowing point and there's no light coming out the other side. That cable's broken. Now, if I violate the bend radius, you're gonna see that that light increases and this light will diminish. It may be hard to see on the TV. But if I crack this, which does take a good amount of force because we do use premium cables, that is now the break location in the cable. You can only see this, or mostly can see this, on single mode yellow jacketed cables where there's one fiber, no over jacket, over top multiples. But you can tell if light is coming out the other side of any fiber, whether that's tactical fiber, SMPTE, optical con, or just your typical riser or plenum patch cables. Now that light, how much light is passing through your cable is your optical budget. It's important that you understand your optical budget, that every piece of dirt or grime and every interconnect causes additional loss in that network system. So when you're connecting multiple and multiple cables, over time you have more and more loss. At some point you're gonna just have failure, digital roll-off. At some point you have too much dB of loss for your network to connect properly, or maybe portions of your signal aren't there that you don't realize. So certainly inspecting and cleaning is critical of your fiber optic cables. Now a cable is comprised of a single strand of fiber typically, with some coating, cladding, strength members surrounding that to ensure that it has some crush strength. Now that coating and cladding helps maintain the bend radius or ensure that, like this highly flexible patch cable we supply, it doesn't break when you violate the bend radius. When you go back, it's good again. Now one thing I must mention is a dust cap is also a dust trap. When that cable is deployed and that cap is sitting around, all that particulate in the air and dirt can easily get trapped inside that cap. The reason I mention that is as you'll find through all of our tips, you always want to clean your fiber optic cable. Whether it's a new cable coming out of a bag or a used cable in the field that you're deploying that was clean yesterday, simply Maintaining it with the dust caps and cleaning your cable is critical to ensuring that your cable is not the weakest link in your fiber optic chain.